In RT traffic shaping, traffic is divided into T bit frames, and a flow can inject less than or equal to R bits in any T bit frame. If the sender wants to send more than one packet of R bits, it simply has to wait until the next T bit frame. A flow that obeys this rule has what's known as an RT smooth traffic shape. In the case of RT smooth traffic shaping, one cannot send a packet that's larger than R bits long. Now, unless T is very long, the maximum packet size may be very small. So the range of behaviors is typically limited to fixed rate flows. Variable flows have to request data rates that are equal to the peak rate, which is incredibly wasteful if you have to configure the shaper such that the average rate must support whatever peak rate the variable rate flow may send. The RT traffic shaper is slightly relaxed from a simple leaky bucket because rather than sending one packet every time unit, the flow can send a certain number of bits every time unit. Now there's a question of what to do when a flow exceeds a particular rate, and typically what's done is that if a flow exceeds its rate, the excess packets in that flow are given a lower priority. And if the network is heavily loaded or congested, the packets from a flow that exceeds a rate may be preferentially dropped. Priorities might be assigned at the sender or at the network. At the sender, the application may mark its own packets, since the application knows best which packets may be less important. In the network, the routers may mark packets with a lower priority, which is sometimes called policing.